For the coronation, remember, Saturday night, 8 p.m. is when the actual service takes place. You'll see it here on Sky News. The couple of hours before will be magnificent pre-coverage. Danica DiGiorgio doing a fantastic job for us, along with the rest of the team in London right now. Well, the preparations are happening in the middle of the night. This thing is going to be beautiful and wonderful to watch. But Australia, well, if you want the chance to be able to swear allegiance to the new king, you will be able to do it. And you'll be able to do it at Madame Tussauds, because they've just released brand new wax figures of the king, future king and future queen. So if you really need to pledge your allegiance, it's actually pretty good, isn't it? Not entirely sure about William, but still, that's one heck of a candle at some point into the time. Which, of course, brings us to, well, the real weird news of the day, which, of course, involves Lidia Thorpe, the single most unlucky senator in Australian political history. Remember, the Mardi Gras, it was because she was looking for somewhere just to lie down because of those netball injuries, the concussions that she spoke about with Neil Mitchell. Well, she has now, among with others, decided to send a letter to the king, not congratulating him on the ceremony that will take place this weekend, but instead demanding reparations from the royal family for its role in colonisation. Lidia Thorpe told NITV today the so-called king, well, he is the king, needs to be held accountable. Basically, we're all experiencing the effects of colonisation and the attempted genocide of our people. We are still picking up the pieces. There's a lot of stolen wealth and the royal family is responsible for. They are in receipt of stolen goods.